Thank you for the opportunity to briefly review sensitive skin and to discuss some potential mechanisms. This is a long-standing quandary in dermatology, well known in the vernacular to patients, the concept generally understood by clinician, and yet its multiplicity and potential pathophysiologic causes creates the vexing issue of poor treatment and capacity to mitigate the symptoms without consequences. These are my disclosures. And whether it's seasonal allergic conjunctivitis with periocular dermatitis, perioral dermatitis or rosacea-like dermatitis, allergic contact dermatitis from any identifiable provocateur, or atopic dermatitis here with some overlying allergic contact dermatitis, all of these patients will report a unified finding: sensitive skin. And we can generally define sensitive skin as either clinically noticeable or without any apparent clinical disease, an uncomfortable sensation of stinging, burning, itching, pain, or tingling. And in the sensitive skin definition, the sensory activity is out of proportion to the provocation that may or may not be accompanied by redness or other findings, and the face is really commonly involved. Now, from a clinical perspective, this often translates into intolerance to topical medication or persistent or recalcitrant sensation that causes distractions to accomplishing activities of routine daily living and work. I've listed a number of dermatoses that are commonly associated with sensitive skin. And to add to this dilemma, if we put them into broad groups, the treatment of one can sometimes aggravate the other. And the example here is I've listed on the top right all of the eczematous dermatoses, right? They all fall into that one group. And perhaps on the face, one might treat with a topical steroid, but that may provoke the formation or worsening of acne and rosacea. Or the patient with rosacea-like dermatitis with sensitive skin who might use a retinoid for acne or benzoyl peroxide, which can aggravate irritant dermatitis or atopic dermatitis in some people. So irritant dermatitis, a very common disease associated with sensitive skin and burning, it's non-immunologically initiated. Of course, an immunologic disease, but it starts off as a direct cytotoxic effect of single, usually more extreme pHs and temperatures and concentrations, or repeated low-grade applications of chemicals that cause this insult. And as I mentioned, strong pHs in the acid or base are going to cause irritant dermatitis, but weaker irritants like soaps and solvents cause irritant dermatitis through repetitive action like hand washing. Contact dermatitis of many sorts is associated with itch. And, you know, we used to always sort of categorize allergic contact dermatitis into Th1 activity. And in fact, there's some data to suggest nickel promotes strong Th1 and Th17 polarization. But if a standard allergen series has 70 allergens or 80 allergens, it is certainly not one set of mechanisms that causes the contact dermatitis to all of them. Fragrances have been demonstrated to provoke Th2 and Th22-like hypersensitivity. IL-31, a well-known itch cytokine, is present in allergic contact dermatitis, and it doesn't seem to correlate to the allergen, but it's there. And IL-33 signaling may be important for certain forms of allergic contact dermatitis and has been demonstrated in some models. Another issue that comes up with burning, stinging, and an uncomfortable face or area of skin are these non-neuronal transient receptor potentials, these TRPV ion channels and TRPA, right? In contact dermatitis, these ion channels that are non-neuronal have been activated in mouse models with squaric acid. They're very important causes of the burning and stinging of rosacea and facial dermatitis like granulomatous or perioral dermatitis. These patients constantly complain of burning and stinging. TRPV1 are on keratinocytes and can sense spices or spicy foods. The V2 are on keratinocytes and blood vessels and can activate in heat. So patients have intolerance to even small fluctuations in the room temperature. V3 can be activated by innocuous warm temperatures and give the impression of very hot feeling. The V4 can activate mast cells and induce innate immunity. TRPA1 may be associated with tacrolimus-associated burning and stinging, which we deal with in patients with eczema all the time. So you might imagine this gentleman to the right trying to put any number of topical medications on and being intolerant to them. I wanted to mention innate immunity and the toll-like receptors. Toll-like receptors are pattern recognition receptors. If I show you a sea of yellow tulips, it is not hard for you to recognize a break-in pattern for the red tulip. You don't have to scan every row to find it. But if I said, identify the trouble person who's got a green shirt on, and then you say, well, there are various colors of green, and I'm not sure if I can identify which person in this crowd is the issue. So these pattern recognition receptors look for breaks in routine patterns and activate them. Toll-like receptors can respond to chemical and physical triggers, microbes, and ultraviolet light. TLR2 is highly expressed in rosacea patients and may be responsible for a good part of the pathophysiology there. They're not, TLR2 is not increased in psoriasis and AD, but nickel can trigger TLR4 and can trigger it in a way that's unique from bacterial lipopolysaccharides. So it probably participates in a variety of sensitive skin syndromes. And I'm just using propylene glycol as an example of a chemical that can cause irritant contact dermatitis, allergic dermatitis, contact urticaria, and typically subjective sensory irritation, particularly on inflamed skin or impaired barriers. It's very common and tends to be in lots of medications. When we see a positive patch, it's very easy to identify to remove it. But when the patch tests are negative, the burning and stinging of medications can be very elusive to determine the cause. So sensitive skin is a complex disorder. It's caused by a variety of protean pathophysiologies, and it's an intolerance to normally well-tolerated exposure. That's how you split it apart. And our headwinds are treating patients with topicals who very often can't tolerate them and trying to get their disease that's causing sensitive skin under better control. Thank you so much for your kind invitation and attention.